Welcome friends, today we will study about the introduction to superconductivity. The superconductivity was discovered in 1911 when the scientist named Kamerlingh Ohm started studying the properties of mercury at very low temperature. It's actually a liquid helium temperature, which is 4.2 Kelvin. He started the study of mercury, properties of mercury at low temperature in 1908, and he found in 1911 that the resistivity of mercury suddenly drops nearly to zero at 4.2 Kelvin. So at this temperature, the resistivity of mercury was of the order of 10 raised to minus 5 times less than its normal resistivity. That means the resistivity is drops to 10 raised to minus 5 times. So the conductivity definitely increases by the 10 raised to 5 times. So he named this phenomena as a superconductivity. And we can say that mercury is getting converted into superconducting material at 4.2 Kelvin. So generally, for a normal conductor, the relationship between temperature and resistivity can be shown like this. Suppose we measure the electrical resistivity of various of any particular conductor or metal, say, at various temperature, and if you plot a graph of electrical resistivity versus temperature, then it will have this kind of nature. We can say from this graph that as the temperature increases, the electrical resistivity of metal increases. This happens is due to the increase in the lattice vibration, which opposes the flow of current through it. So the resistivity increases with temperature, or we can say that resistivity decreases as the temperature decreases. Suppose we are measuring this particular resistivity at a particular temperature, and then we can assume that if we could further cool down this metal up to 0 degree Kelvin, then we will get a particular point, namely rho zero, which is known as absolute resistivity, which is the intersection on y-axis. This rho zero will be the absolute resistivity at 0 degree Kelvin. But in actually, Kamerlingh found that up to certain temperature, the resistivity drops with decrement in temperature. But after a particular temperature, suddenly the resistivity drops nearly to zero. So the material in which this type of things are happening, they are known as superconductor. This phenomena is called superconductivity. And the temperature at which this material gets converted into superconductor, this temperature is called TC. It is critical temperature or transition temperature. So let us summarize the things. At very low temperature, a normal conductor has some resistivity, but for a superconductor, the resistivity is suddenly drops to zero at very low temperature. This TC is the transition temperature. It can be defined as the temperature at which the normal conductor is converted into a superconductor. It is also known as the critical temperature. So, thank you, friends.